لله الحمد لله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gathered us here on His obedience. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among who would gather in Jannat al-Na'im. Allahumma ameen. Ramadan is almost over. It's only a few nights. And the khayr and the ujur, or the multiplied rewards, are in those a few nights that are left. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to intensify our ibadat and to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, the goal is to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The goal is to recite the Quran and to follow the orders of the Quran. Those are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as has been said, if you wanted to speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you make a prayer, you make dua. But if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to speak to you, you read the Quran. Dear brothers and sisters, in those blessed nights, we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us attend and witness Laylatul Qadr. We don't know if Laylatul Qadr passed us already or it's coming. But why is this night so great? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it in the Quran in two surahs. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr laylatul qadr khayrun min alf shahr tanazzalu al malaikatu war ruhu fiha bi idni rabbihim min kulli amr salamun hiya hatta matla al fajr. And in surah al-Dukhan, inna anzalnahu fi laylatil mubarakah inna kunna mundirin fiha yufraqu kullu amrin hakim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it Laylatul Qadr. And Al-Qadr has different meanings. Among them, rif'atul makana, ulumul makana. It's something so great, so virtuous, so precious. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that night He revealed the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it the blessed night, Laylatul Mubarakah. And that is where the blessing and the barakah is kathratul khayr wa thubutu. That means there's plenty of khayr, and that will stick with us inshaAllah. And the reward on that night is, as we all know, 1,000 months, 30,000 nights, 83 plus years. You do one thing on that night, it's like you have done it more than our lives. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us witness that night. There's one thing I wanted to remind myself and all of us inshallah. There is something so crucial on that night that happens that sometimes many of us, we do not pay attention to. And that is, and that mentioned in those two surahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ. On the other hand, Surah Al-Dukhan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فِيهَا يُفْرَقُ كُلُّ أَمْرٍ حَكِيمٍ. The meaning of those, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on that night, and I repeat, on that night, the orders will be given to the angels to come and execute everything that will happen from that night on to the next night, to the next Laylatul Qadr. And that is called Al-Qadra Al-Hawli. That means anything that has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preordained to happen on that year, it will be executed. And the orders will be given. So that means on that night, it will be decided who's going to live, who's going to die, who's going to be honored, who's going to be disgraced. الأجال والأعمار والأرزاق. That is, it can happen that one of those of your main things that we may not make it to the next Ramadan. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us appreciate that night and make us work hard every night and consider it as Laylatul Qadr. Allahumma ameen. Brothers and sisters, when we sit in that night and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to make sure that we connect. And I say, stay connected. You know, all of us heard that term, stay connected. And we all relate to this. No, yeah. Alhamdulillah, we have so much technology now that you are connected wherever you go on the face of earth. But this is not the connection that Allah wants us to be, stay connected. And in order to be connected to Allah, we have to disconnect from everything else. And those nights, make sure anytime the adhan of Maghrib and you make iftar, remember to connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anything else you do should be on the back burner, on the shelf. It can be done later. But we cannot afford to miss this opportunity, this khayr that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an extra night to live. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us one more day, the only one will benefit from that, listen to this, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. He has made the day and night, and it will be given to those who لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make me and you among those who are being mindful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember, brothers and sisters, shukrullah, to say we are grateful to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't mean the words or the lip service. It's not enough to say, oh Allah, thank you. Grateful, that means the iman. Grateful, that means the deed. And grateful, it means you do all these ibadat and following the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To thank Him on those bounties that He gave us. And among those bounties that He made us live through another night and another day. SubhanAllah. You know, we all know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was given the glad tidings in Surah Al-Fath. Inna fatahna laka fathan mubina liyaghfir Allahu laka ma taqaddama min dhanbika wa ma ta'akhkhar. He has been chosen. He's among the best mursaleen, and he was given the Jannah, and all his sins have been forgiven. Yet Aisha radiallahu anha noted him that he would be up all night. حتى تتفطر قدماه. Allah, that his feet, you know, if you read the explanation, it says تفطر means it's swell. It's beyond swell. And if you go to the word يتفطر, it means ينشق انشقاق. Till his skin cracks from the swell. SubhanAllah. So when Aisha, she was so worried about him, said, oh Prophet of Allah, you already made it to Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the glad tidings. And he said, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. This is how we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So dear brothers and sisters, let's recognize those bounties that Allah has given us. And that is the first step in thanking Allah. When you realize, when we realize everything we have is from Allah, that is the start of shukr. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us grateful and thankful to Him. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, I wanted just to remind you, inshallah, make sure you pay zakat, and make sure you pay zakat al-fitr, and make sure you pay your zakat and all the duties. Wallahi, I just attended a funeral to a friend of mine, a family friend, and I just regret to say that many of us sometimes we are so, have so much shortcomings on those things. We can't guarantee our ajal. So let's do it as soon as we can. Do it as like you're not going to live an extra second, because we may regret that we did not do it and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tawfiq. So make sure inshaAllah you remember the masjid, you remember the relatives, and do charity, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us the best for this. Allahumma ameen. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم اجعلنا ممن صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا واجعلنا ممن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا واجعلنا ممن قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا اللهم تقبل صيامنا وتقبل قيامنا وتقبل تلاوتنا وتقبل صدقاتنا وتقبل صالح أعمالنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم أمواتنا وأموات المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين ووحد صفوفهم وانصرهم على أعدائهم اللهم ارفع الظلم عن المظلومين اللهم ارفع الظلم عن المظلومين اللهم ارفع الظلم عن المظلومين اللهم ارزقنا صحبة حبيبك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واسقنا من حوله الشريف شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا اللهم إنا نسألك العلا من الجنة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة